Don Rickles, everybody!
You're fine.
I thank you, audience. I thank you so much. And I must get this off my chest.
Yes, go on.
Go to a dentist.
What the hell is wrong with you?
When did you get so aggressive? What the hell's wrong with you? When we first met, it was, "Hello, Mr. Rickles, how are you?" Now it's, "What the hell's wrong?" Like an equal, you're talking to me, for crying out loud. He became an American citizen. He thinks he can hang out with me, for crying out loud.
I didn't quite say that.
And they sent your papers. I want to be American. All right. Okay, Scotsman, go in the back and clean up the room.
Hey, no, come on. No, you don't want
to... You know, on television, it looks like you got a massive audience. You got 6 Jews and 3 Italians. That's it. Oh, yeah, and one Irish guy sitting there going... Oh, there's a black brother. Oh, yeah. Bless you. Is it a holiday? God bless you, baby.
Dawn.
I'm talking to the black
right
man.
Here,
huh?
Mister, right here.
This guy's important. They get moody. There's no baseball.
Hey, nice stuff.
It's a different world now.
Okay.
All right, listen. I'll tell you what I'm looking at right here.
Why did you...
Well, okay. This is important. I want you to pay attention.
You're not a judge. You're a person.
Look, I'm trying to tell you. I'm looking at this. This is the dates that you're playing coming up, right? February 27th, the King Center in Melbourne, Florida, right? March 2nd and 3rd, the Seminole, is that how you say it? Seminole Hard Rock Hotel in Hollywood, Florida. March 20th to 23rd, the Orleans Casino in Las Vegas. And should you really be working? You've probably got a lot of money by now. Why are you working so much?
Because I'm Jewish and my wife needs jewelry.
You must have money by now. You can't be going
How
out...
How do you know what I have money? A Scotchman asking about money.
I think about money.
No, I love the work as you do, Greg.
Right.
Greg, yeah. I always call you Greg. You know.
Yeah, I know. It's...
Does it matter on the sign? Nobody cares.
That's fair. It's part of your
job. They just show up because it's a long line. There's a line. Let's get that line. Anyway. They think it's Bob Barker. I'll tell you this.
It's his suit.
It's his suit.
Yeah, it is.
One for the Scotchman.
All right, thank you.
Anyway, no, I enjoy the stage, and, you know, as you know, the traveling is always a little bit annoying, but I take jets. What do you take, bus?
Yeah, I take the bus, yeah.
But I enjoy the stage.
You take jets?
How long have you had that?
Yeah.
All get that when they get rich. They all go, When I first met him, it was, "Hello, Don, how are you?" Now it's,
You know, you really have come after me this time. I don't really understand
you
why.
Know
this. You
why?
Never liked
because
this
because she became an American citizen.
Well,
and I voted against it. I voted against it. You came up against it, and I said to immigration, "Don't let this guy get over the fence." Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were Mexican. Anyway, I got nothing against the Mexican people. I love them. I eat the tacos and go, ooh, ooh. Anyway, I'll tell you this. Is this too fast for you?
No, I'll keep it up. Yeah.
And you know what? You're a great host. No, you're beautiful. And that's good. You know what, Greg?
We
go back a long time. Peter LaSalle was the first guy that introduced us.
He was, that's right.
And Peter LaSalle was Johnny Carson's producer, rest his soul. I miss Johnny.
Mm-hmm.
And no offense to you, but he was great.
I know. That's fair.
No, it's fair. No, that's a little below the belt, but who cares?
No, that's right.
Well, look at your notes. Say something.
No, I'm waiting for you to stop so I can find out why you actually are out working all the time. And you said that you take jets. Do you have a private jet? That's what I was going to ask.
Yes. I put wings on my ass and fly.
Right.
Something. Can I really genuinely ask you a question?
Certainly.
Will you just allow me that once?
Okay. All don't right. beg. Don't beg.
No, well, I'm just saying. When you come to the show, which is always a great pleasure for me,
thank
as you know.
Thank you.
I'm always amazed at the size of the posse that you bring. You bring a lot of people with you. A lot of people. A posse. It's an American word. Look it up. I'm catching it.
Coming for you.
No, you probably...
No, I have a friend, Tony O, who's my road manager. Paul Sheffield is my publicist. And my manager, Elliot Weissman, who's in Florida planting trees.
Yeah. But John Stamos is always with you.
Stamos is a great Greek that follows me around going, oopa, oopa, and I give him a cookie and he goes away.
What is the deal with you and Stamos?
John and I met many years ago, and he comes to Vegas, not like you, but before you, and came to about 12 shows in a row, what have you, and he lost his dad, rest his soul, and he always had a thing about me that I represent his father's image, and I was very sweet of him, and I love John, and he's great, and he's 44 years old, and he looks around for 12-year-old girls, got a minute?
Yeah. Anyway,
that's uncruel, it's not, he's not looking for girls. Anyway, see, when you get older, this happens. The other one just his legs dead. This.
All right, that's enough. We have to take a break. We'll be right back with Don Rickles, everybody. Welcome back, everybody. So I got this book. It's written by the comedy legend who's just won 2 Emmy Awards. It's a very new book. It's very, very clever title, Rickles Letters. And it's and it's a bunch of letters written by the comedy legend that is Don Rickles. And look, there's one to me. Yeah, it's really, really flattering as well. We'll talk about that. Please welcome the legend that is America's treasure, Don Rickles, everybody. Don, you'll just get him started.
Okay, that's about it for me.
Yeah. No. Very nice to see you, Don.
Wait a minute. Let me thank them, huh?
Well, okay, then. Come on.
Stop. Pull yourself together. This is an important night for me.
Really?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was very kind. And you know, as you get older and get in this business a long time, it's great when people receive you as you do, and I thank you so much. And for that, no. Okay. Now, getting back to you, the monologue was weak.
The monologue was weak. I thought you might notice.
Not really.
No.
I make fun of Greg. We were at a dinner party together with Regis Philbin, remember?
Yeah. I always like going out with Regis because you know where your money's going to go.
Yeah. No. Sweetheart.
Yeah.
Anyway, what is it? What are you, a wrestling referee?
I'm just trying to keep the audience awake. Come on.
Well, you only got 7 people here. What are you making a fuss for?
They're all paid. We can't afford anymore.
Anything great?
Yeah.
Listen
to your book of letters, right? Yeah. I can I read out a little bit of the letter you sent to me?
What is this, Germany?
Yeah. All right. Dear Craig, I'm writing to give you an alert. Work on your accent. I know you became a US citizen, but after watching many of your shows, immigration has taken another long, hard look at your credentials. They're seriously considering pressing charges and sending you back to your native Scotland, where you'll be more comfortable doing your former job herding sheep. It It's amazing how a guy in a kilt got to be a big star. It's kind of odd, though, that the whole audience lays on the floor looking up. From what I've heard, there's not much to see. Yours truly, Don Rickles. Now, come on! You get to a lot of people in here, my friend.
Yeah, well, it's a fun thing to write. I imagined a book I'd write to all kinds of friends, living or dead, you know, and thank God you're alive. And I said, as a mercy thing, I'd put you in the book. but no, you're a friend, and I wanted to say a few words about you.
Did you put Trump in the book?
How long have you had that?
What?
Anyway,
did what?
I'm working with a guy with a problem. Makes $7 million a week, and he stands here going,
$7 million a week? How can you sit there and say that? You know CBS.
Why are you hollering? You're going back to Scotland in the morning.
Come on. How can you say it
to me? Why is he dressed up like a yo-yo over there? Why?
You can't say yo-yo anymore. You have to say yo-yo American. You got letters in here to God.
Yeah, it's an interesting book, but why talk about that? It's a hit, and I don't need it.
Oh, really?
Anyway.
All right. Listen, congratulations about the Emmys, by the way. It was so fantastic
before
to see
I say
you
that, by the way, David Ritz, a fine writer, helped me put this together. And I think for Christmas and so forth, it's an interesting thing. My wife needs jewelry.
Yeah, yeah. I think she'll be doing okay. It was very nice to see you getting these well-deserved Emmys at that fantastic show we
went. Well, you know, Craig, and you, ladies and gentlemen, you know, being in this business 55 years and my age, I was so delighted, really, to receive an Emmy. You know, it's your peers, and it's a thing called... And as you know, Craig, it's called Mr. Warmth, the Don Rickles Project, and my son Larry and John Landis, a wonderful director, and Bob Engelman and Mike Richardson, they all helped put it together. And Tony O and Paul Sheffer, we had a great team, and they just, we went to different actors. The guy I adore amongst many, Clint Eastwood is one of my guys.
Clint Eastwood, yeah.
But going to Bob De Niro and asking him to do the part, we said, Bob, Don would like you to say a few words. He went, Well, what do you want me to say? Well, and John said, well, say he's a good actor. He's a good actor. These are the kind of things. And Clint, both of these men make fortunes. And they're wonderful gentlemen. They really are, besides being great actors. But you talk to Clint, you say, you know, Clint, how about dinner tomorrow? I did a picture called, why do you lean over? Can't you hear me?
I'm sorry, I can't understand your accent. Oh, what'd you say?
He leans over like we're in court. Hello. No, Greg, I was in... Step back, you're scaring me.
I'm just... Anyway,
Clint Eastwood, you know, and all these...
All right.
You son of a gun.
I know.
You're gay.
I know. European, but it's much the same thing. You were going to tell me about this Clint
Eastwood
thing. What
did you do, just cut meat?
Yeah.
Jump ball.
Tell me about your dinner with Clint Eastwood.
With Clint Eastwood, and Clint's another one kind of guy, but everything is low-key, you know, and they don't like to be seen. And the last time I was with Clint once, we had dinner, and we did a picture called Kelly's Heroes in Yugoslavia.
I love that picture. That's a great picture.
40 years ago.
Really?
Trust me, everybody was going, dobra, dobra, dobra. And, you know, Clint was running around going, dobra, dobra. And when you eat, it made Mexico a warm-up. The runs were like a mystery, I swear to God. Every time I had dinner, I went, oh. And the guy went, dobra, dobra. They put olive oil, Craig, olive oil, buckets of olive oil.
That goes right through you, the olive oil. Where were you?
What are you, a cop?
Yes. That's right, I'm a gay European cop. What? At what point? Actually, it's not a bad idea.
No, so Yugoslavia was a great experience. Sully Savalas, rest his soul, he was something else. I miss him and Carol O'Connor. And in fact, you know, and all these gentlemen, they're we like to think a better world anyway. But the way things are today, I don't know how people say a better world.
Yeah.
But my son goes up in my dressing room, and on the wall has all these actors. And he goes, dead, cancer, dying, dead. And then he looks at me and says, you feel okay?
Oh, You take a lot of that from your kids. They give you a lot of talk back.
Yeah, I got to be nice because if I get in a home someday and I'm spitting up, they're going to be standing over the bed going, Dad, we're not paying for the hospital.
Yeah.
No, they're great. I have a daughter, Mindy, a wonderful daughter and a wonderful son, and they've been good to me. You know, today, our children, you know, it's a cycle. They're going to take care of us eventually.
All right.
And my son and daughter have been very good, and I've been very good to them. And I delve out a few bucks once in a while, and they go, thanks, Dad. And then they go, he's so cheap. Anyway.
Are you going to be with them for Christmas?
Wait, I'm not finished.
Oh, right, okay.
That's a joke about being cheap. That's my daughter will say, Dad, she talks like my wife. My wife is this. She say, sweetheart, how'd you like the show? Just great. Let's go to dinner.
Are you finished?
Yeah.
All right. Are you going to spend Christmas? Do you celebrate Christmas?
Sure. Well, Jews, we can participate. We sell you the trees. I celebrate Christmas Eve, every Christmas Eve, God willing, with our dear friends, the darling Ginny Newhart and her husband Bob Newhart, great comedian and a great friend. And we spend every Christmas together. And my favorite time is when we sit by the tree and he reads the book of Jesus.
I'm not familiar with that one.
And then, Bob is, we've traveled the world together with the Newharts.
Right.
God bless him. Before 9/11, we went all over the world, really. And I, like in Germany, when we were in Germany, you know, we'd walk down the street and Bob would say, don't kid around. Don't say anything. Don't. And I'd go like, Stumm in Heim in Stein.
No, you shouldn't do that in Germany.
And he'd go, don't do that. You're going to get in trouble. But he's a great, great gentleman, and his wife, Jen, and we spend Christmas Eve, and they sing the carols.
You sing carols? You do all that?
No, I stand in the back and figure out how many gifts I had to give.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if you sing the carols or not, because you're Jewish. I don't know if you have to stand back from
Christmas. We have great cantors. You've heard of a cantor.
Oh, yes, of course.
Cantorial chants.
Yes.
We made it up before you guys.
Yes, I know. All I'm saying is, though, but it's not Silent Night, Baby Jesus.
You're starting to get on my nerves. Baby Jesus. Is he in town? Anyway. Three Catholics went,
And you go back out on the road, you do the casinos, don't you?
I sure do. I do the Indian casinos, and the only problem is every time I work, they keep circling the hotel with pain in the ass. They keep circling and bum, and then I have to be nice, and the chief always comes up and goes, we like show what they get when they were. Then I gotta go outside and wash their horse, for crying out loud.
Don, I played at Indian casinos. That's not true. You're just making
that
up.
Well, that's why I'm a star and you're sitting
on
the desk.
All right. I guess that's the way it is. Don Rickles, everybody. All right, man. Please welcome the legend that is Don Rickles, everybody. Don. Don, welcome.
Okay, that's it for me.
Yeah. How are you, Don?
It's not bad. It's not a carnival. It's a show.
Hey, it's not
nice big. Young people. You have a nice young audience, really. Nice. Except the guy here in the front with the Washington haircut.
Yeah.
Get him a cherry tree and get him out of here. Okay, how you been?
I'm good. Don't pick on the man.
How long have you had that?
I don't have that.
No, you're good.
It's the heat's getting to me. It's August. I always get like this in August.
A lot of good talk about your show. A lot of people have been telling me they're turning it on.
Really?
12:30 at night when the wife's just laying there going, sweetheart, you want to fool around? I said, no, Greg's on. Greg's on.
Yeah, all right.
When you're married 44 years, you got a Jewish wife, she just lays there and goes,
oh.
You young people will find out it's not all the big job, you know? There's more to it. Now, you gotta enjoy life. How long are you married now?
6 months.
Ah, good. He's really crazy about it, isn't he? 6 months.
No, I was doing that thing.
I heard that this has just come out in Canada. Congratulations.
Well,
I didn't know you made it in Canada.
Well, what are you talking to me like I'm a Mountie? I'm not a Mountie.
Canada, that's the big time.
Howard Blank and all those people up in Vancouver and all the great people up there. And I'm delighted that it's on there. And by the way, I won 2 Emmys for that.
Yeah, right, yeah. Shut up.
You can keep the applause down.
Yeah.
No, 2 Emmys, you know, I'm in the business 50 years.
50 years.
And I said, what is this, on tape? I know what I'm saying. Yeah,
What are you,
Playback Charlie? Talking to the FBI. Yeah, where were you? In the car. Don't do that unless your apartment needs heat.
Yeah, all right.
You don't remember that in New York when we were struggling actors. We used to do, all right, I'll turn on the heat. Anyway. I didn't have to go there. Sit up. It's not a toilet. Sit up. Guy's sitting here in shorts like this. You want a magazine? Anyway, they don't understand that. They said, that's too fast. I forgot where I was working. Put up the signs. Anyway, so I went.
You don't have signs?
That was good the way you turned around like that. That really helps.
I'll do it again.
Helps the joke that went in the toilet.
I'm here to help. I'm here to serve.
No need to holler. I'm right on top of you.
No, this is business. That's my thing. I do. Yeah. I yell stuff in a phony Scottish accent.
No, the Scottish accent is great. I've never been to Scotland.
Have you not? They love you there, you know.
Yeah, well, I'm not going.
Why not?
Too many other great places to go. And I have nothing against Scotland. There's Italy. There's Israel. No, I don't want to go to Israel now. I don't feel like ducking. Anyway, I'm a Jew, so there's no problem. The German guy with the rifle. It's a joke.
Hey. There's no chairmans in here.
So, are you going to say I'm a liar?
Yeah, no, I'm not saying you're a liar. I was saying, look, if you remember, I was congratulating you on your newfound fame in Canada.
Yeah, well, only Canada. You know, this very honestly, when John Landis and my son Larry and a great group of people and Tony O and Elliot Weissman and all this put this thing together, it really tells a story of how tough a life a comedian can have and how joyous it can be. And for you young people, it's really something I think you'll enjoy because it tells the personal part of your life and it tells the fun part of your life. And as I hold this in my hand, I want to thank the Academy.
Give it a damn thing. See? You got all these different people. Why am I not in this lineup? You're like everybody else there.
Because you're not big enough.
What? Come on!
No, you're big enough, but I wanted to keep it funny and happy, you know?
Will you stop doing that? You'll break it, for crying out loud. Don't worry. This is the American
stop
one. Not
banging. It's not an X-ray. It's a show, for crying out loud.
Good one, too.
Oh, God bless you, kid. Keep going.
What about the Orleans? You're going to the Orleans. I love that
great
room
hotel,
in the Orleans.
Yeah, it is.
They've got a bowling alley, you know.
I'm not Polish. Anyway, Polish people are great, but they're big in bowling. Jews don't bowl. We own the alley. Anyway, hey, I laughed at your crap. You're going to start laughing at mine.
Oh, God.
Anyway, so why do you sit like that? Are you? Do you think I'm a dentist?
Do you want me to sit next to you? You like me
No.
No, I'm sitting next to you.
I've had enough of this.
I'm sitting next to you. There you go. I don't want you. Hey.
Those are great boots.
Well, thank you.
Those are great boots. Now, that right there, that's your Austin Powers.
These aren't bad.
Boots
these are a little
right
gay, but they're not bad. No, these are great. Your shoes are smart.
Yeah, you happy with those?
What is this, a shoe show? We're doing a regular show here.
No, we're getting a little more daytimey now. I'm asking you about...
Hey, this is great.
It's nice, isn't it? Yeah, I like it. Yeah,
we're on American Airlines. More peanuts.
Yeah.
Remember, you go to Germany, around the world, right, Scotland?
Yeah.
I was just on the airline now, and the girl came up and said, sir, would you care for another round of peanuts? And it's 78 hours, and you get peanuts, you know. And I love when they come, oh, this is the captain. You notice, you can never hear, because I just came from Connecticut. I was up in Foxwoods, and we had from Boston, it's a long ride back, you know. You people, you get out of the house at all, you people?
No.
So when you come back, it's a long trip.
Well, but I love from Foxwoods in Connecticut to Boston, that's like 2 hours.
No, no, don't be a smart ass.
I'm just trying to help you.
Again, you're yelling. Will you stop yelling?
I'm sorry.
Anyway, so you come back and the pilot gets on, you know, like you're maybe 2 hours from Boston out, and you hear, this is the captain speaking. Well, on the inside seat, and it's hot, right? And you know, I'm not a very bad, you see the seatbelt, and I'm buying it, yeah, hot, crash. Anyway, so. I was just thinking that. It's a long, long ride. No, how long, you, the gentleman with the yellow shirt, how long are you married?
What? 10 years.
Do you have to do this? 10 years? You got a little spring on your ass that makes you do that? 10 years? 10 years. God bless you. Third wife? Second wife. See?
Not bad. You were only one off.
You're very stunning. You look like you're very happy. Anyway.
You know when you talk to these people, we have to panel.
Well, with the money you make, you'll get over it. Believe me.
I spoke to
Peter LaSalle, your producer, who said to me, it's a little out of line what he makes. You know, you got to think of it. You were doing comedy sketches on other television shows, and today you're a big star. You're making a lot of money. You got married.
Who are you talking to?
Let me finish. Right. You got a big house in Malibu.
A big house in
That's
Malibu.
Right. I met your son who loves to do magic.
Oh, yeah, my son. Yeah,
your son is like, what, 10, 11?
Eight.
Eight. I'm not a kidnapper. You can tell me the truth.
No, I'm telling you. He's eight.
He's adorable, and he does magic. He comes over to you at a dinner party, which we were at, and he said, right. What's his name again?
Milo.
Right!
Yeah. Anyway.
He got it right! Son of a gun! Anyway. Move up 2 steps. You got it right. Anyway,
I'm really glad I remembered it, actually.
And the kid's adorable. When I'm talking, don't.
Okay,
do
I'm sorry. No.
This guy here in the front's great. He's sitting like this the whole show. What the hell are you, a mannequin?
Will you stop talking to them? We have to pay them. I told you we have to pay
them. Get over it. The whole front row. These guys are great. They really dressed up for the show. They're sitting there in their underwear, for crying out loud. Anyway, his son, adorable kid, he comes up and says, Mr. Rickles, want to see some magic? And I'm having a couple of vodkas, and I'm not in the mood for no 8-year-old kid pulling on my pants to do magic, you know? And he goes, watch this, Mr. Rickles. Boom, disappear. And of course, he's an 8-year-old kid. And you go, so where's the magic? Watch this again, Mr. Rickles. Disappear. So I slapped him in the face, and he went away. No, that's a joke. He's adorable, but he loves to do magic. Tell him I talked about him, okay?
Yeah, well, sure. To be honest, I mean, you're a legend, Don, but with the 8-year-old set, I just don't know how much
weight they'll that's learn going. Someday.
All right,
if
I'm
God
just
lets
saying.
Me live, they'll know someday. Right, oh, well. By the way, yeah. I was in New York recently. I got a segue because you're not a big help.
Okay.
I was in New York.
I'm listening.
And gang, any of you New Yorkers know this. And I love New York. I was born and raised in New York. And so a couple of weeks ago, we're in New York, and we came out of Elaine's. That's a very prominent restaurant there, which we hang out late at night. And we're coming out of Elaine's late at night, and you have these gentlemen that are in bad trouble. You know, I don't want to use the word beggars. They're not beggars. They're people in trouble. Well, they're beggars.
Yeah.
Anyway, but they're people in trouble, really. A lot of homeless. We got a lot of economic problems, which you all know, but I won't get into that. But anyway, so we're walking down the street. My wife and I and a few people. Uh-huh. And a guy says, Mr. Rickles, sir, please. And I use that voice because that's how they sound.
Yeah.
Mr. Rickles, please, help me. Got a few dollars. Give me something, Mr. Rickles. Mr. Rickles. And I always have a set thing that I do all the time. I take a $5 bill out of my pocket and I say, here's $5. Buy yourself a ranch. Okay? And the guy goes, thank you, Mr. Rickles. And we walk away. And usually that's the end of it. And as we're walking up the street, this same man comes running after me. Now, Mr. Rickles, we need cattle.
Don Rickles, everybody. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Drake, and I am the sad gay clown at the head of a mighty robot skeleton army. Or, I'm a middle-aged white guy telling jokes in the middle of the night. Either way, you're here, I'm here. Why not carry on? My next guest. In fact, there's a bit of class now, so behave yourself. He's a comedy icon. He's at the Orleans Hotel in Las Vegas, March the 20th and the 21st. Please welcome the legend that is Don Rickles, everybody.
I agree. No, that's awfully sweetie. Really, I in my career I've gotten applause, but this is cute. When you got an audience of about 12 and they go crazy. Just go crazy.
Yeah, they go. It's a very, very small audience, but they're quality.
Why are you yelling? I'm right on top of you. By the way, it's nice to be back with you. You're a good friend, and I'm delighted to be on your show. I really am. He's a special kind of guy. You know, we've been together socially. We've got to know each other over the years now with Peter LaSalle, his producer, who's in the background wondering if Johnny Carson will call. Johnny, rest his soul, was a great artist.
Oh, yeah, yes. No, absolutely.
That was a great ad lib.
Yeah, no, thanks. I was just trying to remind you I'm here. I'm over here.
I'll remind you of something. Why?
Why? Listen, Don.
No,
Don. Don, listen to me. Listen to me. This is. I need you to concentrate.
Okay.
All right.
What is this, a test? When you hear the bell. When you hear the bell, go to history.
Right. Do you go on the Twitter?
Do you see? You never got. You got your visa. You became an American, and you're still doing it. You still can't get over wearing those funny pants and watching sheep die. Hey, you're in America a long time now. I mean, when I first met him, I got on the show and said, "How are you?" And all your crew went, "Isn't he great? Isn't he great?" Now, come on, you got to start. And listen, do me a favor. There's a new thing out called a hanky. You don't sniff like that. You don't do that. Now, listen, but I want to tell you something. That was good, see? That's talent. When he went... nice to see you.
Yeah, you saw the Swedish girls, didn't you? Yes!
I'm happily married now, darling. And I don't get excited anymore.
Yeah. All right, that's enough now.
Nothing else moves except this. By the way, his name is Spider. Anyway, that's too deep for you. I'm sorry. Show the cards. See, that's cute.
You're still here? I thought you forgot about me. I thought you'd met your new friends from Sweden and you were off.
No, they're young and beautiful.
They are.
Where were you 60 years ago when I was... When I was in heat 24 hours a day.
Yeah.
No, they're beautiful girls. Are you all single girls?
Yes.
Want to go to a party?
Yeah. Knock it off. There's laws against that kind of thing now. That's sexual harassment. You can't talk to an audience like that. You have to respect them.
That was a good speech.
Thanks. No,
okay. See, I let you talk, and where do you go? Right?
Yeah,
the dump.
Yeah,
it doesn't mean anything. So what's new?
Hey, hankies. You were the one that started on the hankies,
that's
and then
good,
you're
there.
But you got,
okay.
There's the one right there.
Okay, Scotsman turns on Jew.
No, that's not fair. That's not fair.
Okay.
I don't think that's fair.
Nah.
How's Barbara all right?
Oh, thank God. I must say, we're married. Well, we're married 45 years.
Wow.
Don't applaud, you never saw her. Anyway, see, that joke will cost me.
That will.
Jewish broads, you gotta come up with a couple of diamonds or something, you know what I mean? She sits around in Malibu, with a ring, signaling ships. Come on, this is funny stuff.
It's great stuff.
If I leave it up to you, we'll be mutes.
No. I'm just working at a slower pace tonight. I'm working at a slower pace.
A slower pace.
How's Barbara then? Is she good? That's what I asked you. How's Barbara? Is she all right?
Well, yeah, but I have a new thing now. She gets up at night.
You have a new thing? She must be happy about that.
And right up one down. Yeah. There you go. Yeah, finally.
Whoa. I was wondering where it was.
I think we were all a little worried. Anyway, we got that, right? Good. Yeah. Enjoy yourself.
But
now.
You're a newly married man. You're a lovely wife.
Yes, she is.
I met her. She's adorable and beautiful.
She is. Mm-hmm.
And it's great. It's going good.
She's Swedish. She's not. She's not. But she kind of could be. She has blonde hair.
She's a lovely girl.
She really is. You like her, don't you?
Yeah, I like her so.
No, but I mean that last party we were at. You
what
were
am
kinda,
I, Tiger
like,
Woods?
That,
I got a lot
no,
on
no,
my
no,
mind.
You were getting a little bit grabby.
not me.
Yes, you.
That was you in the back of with the waitress going.
Hey, no.
No,
not me, John. I'm a sad gay clown.
I never get horny like that. Spider goes to sleep at night. When you get older, you get in bed, get in the pajamas, and the big guy goes. In the old days, when I was your age, got in the pajamas, and he went, when I was single.
No.
Always searching. And then when I was younger, when I was 18, 19 in the Navy, you know, we used to talk about broads and widows, tight pants, and all of a sudden you look down and you said, is that a boil? See, you weren't in the service.
No, I wasn't in the Navy, no. Well, I dressed as a sailor a couple of times. But I wasn't in the Navy.
I was in the Navy.
How long were you in the Navy for then?
Oh, about 30 years. No, I was in the Navy 2.5 years, World War II.
Where were you, Pacific?
No, Spain. No. I was in the Philippines, Tacloban, Lingayen Gulf, Cebu. I was on PTs. I kept saying, I said, I'm a comedian. This is true. I said, I'm a comedian, I do jokes. I said, keep firing. I said, no, you don't understand, sir. Joke. Keep firing. And now they all come to Vegas, watch the show, and go, funny guy. And I gotta kiss their ass so my grandchildren get toys.
Hey, no. Hey, you know, we gotta take a commercial break. Are you okay with that?
No, sure. Hey, with the salary you get, take everything
all
you
right.
can get.
All right, we'll take a commercial break. I'm trying to be nice to you, but you keep interrupting me. What's it now?
Before I forget, because we're good friends, so I can take this liberty.
Okay.
My manager's been under the weather. His name is Elliot Weissman, and he's had some problems with his health, but I just wanted to let him know that we're thinking of him and wish him good things.
On that note of managing your career, I said earlier on that you were at the Orleans Casino in March, but it's February, apparently. It's February the 20th and the 21st. I'm just writing it down here, next to that excellent joke that
I told. And then pick up some chopped liver and boom, boom, boom.
Yeah, chopped liver.
And a bagel.
Diamonds for Barbara.
She's got that.
Hey, the Orleans is a great place, isn't it? I like that casino.
And
I used to go there.
What do you think of Vegas? It's new to you compared to my years. I've been there 50 years.
It seems like a big corporate event to me. I mean, when you were there with Frank and Dean and Sammy, and all that was a very different time.
Yeah, what happened to them? Anyway,
I don't want to be the one to tell you.
No. And I don't want to make too many jokes.
Yeah,
some of their friends are alive and we can stand here going, no!
Yeah.
No, there were great times. Mr. Sinatra, rest his soul, was a great friend to Barbara and I, and his lovely wife Barbara is still with us. And he was a great man. He had some dark sides about him, but to know him was to love him. And then Dean was great. All those guys and Sammy, we had some great fun. Today, it's like
Vegas is very different.
Well, sure. You have a cup of coffee. The guy goes, cup of coffee. Four. Here's your chit. Here's your card. Here's your boom. Boom.
Hey, your watch.
Hey.
Come on, let me see it.
The Jew wants to go with you. Remember those kind of guys?
I would say,
anyway, so it was great because it had an atmosphere of the tough guys were always great to the actors. Now, today it's different. Everybody is wonderful, I must say, but it's more corporate. You know, it's more, for everything advances. It's now more of a Disneyland kind of atmosphere where you can bring your family and your kids.
And also prostitutes. There's still prostitutes.
Don't be crude. I hate that when you're crude.
Talked about your penis called Spider to the Swedish girls. And then you say, but why am I being crude?
You're out of control.
Well, I'm just saying, you've upset me because you said...
You're out of control, damn it. Now, I can't take too much more. You're out of control. I'm trying to be nice. Don't sting me.
All right.
They come over here from another country with a dress.
Don't start with that.
Well, how long have you been a citizen?
A year. Two years.
Well, you're going back.
What? No, you can't. John, we have to take, apparently, yet another commercial break. Will you stick around?
Oh, sure. It's a mercy thing.
Yeah, well, thank you. Welcome to the Don Rickles Show. I'm his sidekick, the sad gay clown from another country. We were talking about Las Vegas.
By the way, you know what's on tonight? It's done already. Regis was on with his wife, Joy.
On Dave?
On Letterman. Yeah, know, the guy you walk around behind his car and go... Hey, don't be embarrassed. Hey, for the money you get, you should do that. Do that.
Do what? Go behind his car and go...
Yeah.
Why would I do that?
I know what I said. What is this, on tape? I know what the hell we said.
I'm just making sure.
Gee, I'm checking everything I say anymore. This gentleman here, sir, would you sit up? This is not a toilet, if you don't
mind. Yeah, come on. Sit up.
No, it's a truck.
It's a guy in front of you. You were sliced over.
He was.
No, you're right. He was sliced over.
How about a magazine? You want a magazine?
Yeah.
Get him a magazine.
We got visitors from another country here, pal. You talk about me sitting all slouched over like that.
Isn't he great?
Regis was on, Dave. Did you watch it? It was fantastic. I loved it.
No, Regis really believes he's Pavarotti. Forget about it.
Yeah, I know.
But he's a darling man, and so is Joy. They're great people.
No, Regis is coming here. He wants me to sing a song with him that night.
But you know what? Reading your book, you did everything. You're a fine singer, too.
No. I just put that in the book. It's a lie, though.
No, you can sing.
No, a little bit. Yeah.
You had quite a life. You know what? I didn't realize... what you went through. You went to get to the big time like this, it really was...
Come on.
No, I'm not going to... Without a band, with a small little group and a tiny studio that nobody cares about. You've really gotten big, and that's great.
Big for me.
Hey, I'm 83, and I'm kissing up to you because I'm going no place.
No way you're 83. You're not 83. You're 83?
I'm 83.
You must moisturize. You moisturize?
In May, I'll be 84. 84 in May, gang. Not bad, huh?
Yeah. Hey, what day is your birth? My birth is in May.
May 8th, me, you, and Harry Truman. When was yours?
May 17th.
That's a bad number.
No, come on.
No, God bless you.
That means you're a Taurus and I'm a Taurus.
That's why we get along.
We get along.
Let's get some broads and get out of here.
Yeah. Come on, Swedish girls.
You don't want old man. Yeah, he's young. You have me to forget about.
I
just lay in bed now and just spit up a little bit.
Yeah. More diamonds for Barbara.
That's right.
So listen, you're going back to Vegas. Are you out in the road? You're doing more stand-up around the country, kind of thing?
Thank you. I really am. I'm enjoying it. I just came back from a place that you were at, where both of us were, Austin, Texas.
I love it down there. I'm going down there soon to Texas.
Oh, you're going back? Yeah. I loved it there, too. They were great to us. The theater, yeah.
Yeah. And did you have a look around the town of Austin?
Oh, yeah. You know, a lot of guys come up to me and went...
Yeah.
But, and they didn't even have a saddle on them. It was one of those. Hey, lady, this is what you're going to hear. It's free. The woman with the guy that's going to...
I know, the guy that was sledging. I know, I saw it. Yeah.
Billy Graham will come in a minute and help your hand to get better, you know. You know, I think of that because my biggest thrill in life, really, and I think... I'll ask you that same question.
Okay.
My biggest thrill in my career up to date was being in Washington, D.C., at the Kennedy Center for Ronald Reagan, rest his soul, and Frank Sinatra had me on the show. And this is the truth. And Frank called me in Hawaii. I was in Hawaii.
Right.
He says, Don, you're going to be on the inaugural for Ronald Reagan. I said, Frank, you're kidding? Just pack your bags. Do what I tell you. You're going to be there.
Yeah.
Frank goes to Ronald Reagan's cabinet and says, we're going to have Rickles on. No, what are you, crazy? We're going to have Rickles. No, he says, you're going to have Rickles. No. And he said, God rest his soul, he said, if you don't have Rickles, you don't have me.
Oh.
That's the truth. That's how it started out. And then I got to Washington and had the Marine Guard and all that fancy stuff. And they said, well, what is Rickles going to do? And he said, whatever he wants. And I've never been off the color of the road. I really haven't. If you see me in person, you'll realize I say a couple of things, but nothing, you know. The young kids today open with them.
Yeah, that's and, you know, true, yeah.
And hey, I don't put it down. If the people laugh and show up for them, more power to them, but I'm getting a little pissed off. Anyway, no, not really, not really. They're wonderful young comedians, and I'm happy for them.
Oh, I don't like them.
Well, any guy that drinks out of a thing like that, how are you going to like anybody?
I'm telling you, the young comedians with the, hey, have you ever noticed how some things are like other things? No, I'm 47, I've been married 3 times. I never noticed how some things are like other things. Shut the hell up. Do you know what I mean? It's like, hey, have you ever noticed?
Yeah. Funny son of a bitch. Yeah, funny
Anyway, so you're at the inauguration. It's Ronald Reagan.
Yeah,
Frank
Ronald Reagan, right, thank you. And so we're at the inauguration, and I get up there, and bless me, I did Rickles as Rickles does, and I made fun of the president. And Ronald Reagan was a great man. He really was, forgetting your politics, but he was a great man. And I don't say that sarcastically. I mean, really, whatever you believe in. You know, today, it's like today, Obama, God bless him, he's a new president, everybody's happy. But you go to parties here in L.A., and if you like George Bush or if you didn't like George Bush, in my day you said, well, not my cup of tea, or it wasn't my kind of guy. Today you say at a party, you say to me, Don, you know, President Obama, I didn't like the speech you made Friday.
Don, President Obama, I didn't like...
What are you, crazy? What do you mean you didn't like it Friday? What are you, nuts? What are you, nuts? Obama's the greatest. What are you, crazy?
That is insane.
It's true. Absolutely true. Don, we're out of time. I gave you the whole damn show, and we still don't have enough time. You're going to have to come back again and end the story, because we're out of time.
Oh, that's sweet. Yeah, you folks are delightful, and I tell you, being in the company of this man, really, and I got to know him socially as a friend, he and his lovely wife, to know him is to be really blessed, because he's full of warmth, and he's a real booster and a supporter of all of you people. He really is.
Yeah. Well, Don Rickles, everybody. We'll be right back.
Wednesday night edition of In Your Pants.
In Your Pants?
With, my name's Jeff Peterson. My first guest tonight is a young rising star in the stand-up comedy circuit. He's sensational, this kid. On September the 23rd, he's going to be at the Casino Rama in Ontario, Canada. And then on October the 16th and 17th, he's at the Orleans in Las Vegas. Please welcome the rising young star of American comedy, Mr. Don Rickles, everybody. That's enough. Don't get him. He'll get ideas if you start with that.
That was very kind of you, but it should have gone longer. No, thank you very much. I'm very proud of that. You know, as we get older in this business, you're very grateful that the good Lord gives you a chance to perform. And when I see you folks respond, you see us. You know, it's never old. It's like what's in here. So don't ever think you're old.
See, I thought for once you were going to be sincere there. I thought it was going to be a heartfelt moment, and then people would be all excited about it. And there you went, you undercut it again.
Why are you hollering? What are you hollering about? I'm right here.
I'm excited.
You know, that reminds me, it has nothing to do with anything. You know, you young people, you know, Broadway, you know, you ever see the Broadway actors? And I love Broadway. And that's the one thing in my life, I don't know about you, but I never did Broadway, and I did off-Broadway, but never did Broadway proper. I said, gee, if I got a shot on Broadway before I die, that would be great. And I've had a few opportunities, but, you know, it means work. And so,
And so Broadway was always the thing. But if you ever meet a Broadway actor, and you meet them socially, you go, how are you, Tom? I'm pretty good, Don. How are you? Now you meet them the night before the show goes on. Ah, are you excited about the show? I'm fine, Don. How's the family? Are you okay? And then they go on stage. Broadway, my mother knows my dog is dead. Broadway. Broadway. And they talk like this all the time, you know? So that was the story, which you people have no idea what the hell I was talking about.
Hey, that's pretty good, though.
What a night. What a night. You don't have this excitement too often. And when you get to my age, this goes up. Anyway. All right, here's 100 for you for the broad, 200 for me. Does those money bits. He's a lonely guy. He's a lonely
guy.
Yeah,
I'm a lonely guy.
By the way, may I drop this in? But and I really mean this from my heart. This wonderful man, his lovely wife, you're going to have a baby.
We are, yeah.
You have one child.
Yeah, I got a 9-year-old boy, and I've got another one coming. No, another 9-year-old boy. I mean,
isn't he great? Dynamite. Everything he says, dynamite.
Yeah, I see. Sometimes when you do that, I just don't think you're being sincere. I think you're being sincere.
That's a wild guess. No, you're right.
I don't know why you do that. I'm always
because I don't like you.
See, I never liked you.
I respect you, but I don't like you.
I see. I don't even think you respect me. I think
no, that's not true. Okay. I do respect you, because I'm so pissed off that you skyrocketed. I can't believe it. Here, when I met him, he was in Scotland. Going, nah. All right.
Yeah. That was quite a weekend.
I saw you laughing. You like that one. You don't see the host laughing when I do.
No,
you know?
No.
Usually they go off like a lot of them. That son of a bee.
No. Anything with sheep, I'm usually interested.
I won't go there.
You've been over there. You've been over to Scotland. Have you been over there?
No, I never have. We really? Like to go to places where we can have fun.
Oh, see.
I've been over to England. I've been in England, maybe. Well, I love that I go, Mary, Daddy's home. Daddy's home, Mary. Want to take a pop at it, Mary? How about a pop? You know, they don't even know what that is, you know? You know what I love? This guy in the front, guy, little heavy set guy. The guy with my, and he's sitting here like, what's going on, Rose? Sit back. You're a heavy guy. Sit back. Because a couple of minutes, the guy next to you is going to go. Oh, God bless you. Is that your dad? God bless you, Dad. I was only kidding. Dad! The old man, see, you can always tell when they get old because the mouth can't close.
You can't do that, Dad. You can't do that, no.
I'm 84, but I close. Dad, you got to keep the mouth closed. Otherwise, they come on a hook and you're in a box like this. Keep the mouth closed, they'll never know. But as soon as you do this, that's when the guy goes, get the sheet, Lou, get the sheet.
Don, can I just for a second, excuse me, CBS in no way endorses the views of Mr. Don Rickles.
They ought to, because you're going in the dumper without it.
Oh, come on. Come on.
You know, you are a gracious, wonderful man. We got to know each other through Peter LaSalle.
The lovely Peter LaSalle. He produces this show.
Yeah, he's in the wonderful control room, and this is what he does. But he's a charming guy, and he takes care of you, and he was with Johnny Carson, who... did you know Johnny?
No, I never met Johnny.
He was... Rest his soul, you young people, and the oldest, too. He was a magnificent host, as well as this gentleman is. And Johnny was there. And made it possible for guys like my friend Greg to be that successful.
Why do you always call me Greg? My name's Craig. You call me Greg all the time. You know me for years. You know me for, you know, I've known you for like 7 years now. You still call me Greg. Why do you call me Greg?
Because it's not going to change Frank. Your career. Is it going to change it? Well, you're going to have more people in this closet? What are you kidding? The room seats 200 maybe, and one against the wall on a hook, and he's worried. He's worried. Is his name Craig or Krug? Who cares? Get up in the morning and say, bah. When does the dummy talk?
Call me a hockey puck, just once. Hey, Rickles, who's the dummy now?
Hey, hey, hey. Old, Don.
How do you challenge a toy? Anyway,
in your pants.
What did he say?
He said, in your pants.
In
he
your
says
pants.
It all the time. No.
God bless him. Yeah. I want his name and I want him dead.
Yeah. That's the trouble. He's already dead. Yeah. He's just...
Yep.
Yeah. We have to take a break now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's get back to Wes, and when you're through smelling your hand, we'll continue.
Yeah. I'll be right back.
Do that.
That was very sweet. No, I didn't have him do it. They did it. No, I swear. Welcome back, everybody. I'm here with my friend Don Rickles. Now, I say he is my friend. I know he pretends like he's not my friend.
No, but we are.
We're friends. Now, you, kinda. when did we meet? We met when I first started the show, didn't we?
Yeah, well, Peter LaSalle again. Peter, who's an old friend and a good friend. He's not old. He's, well,
he's pretty old. You see him walking around like.
What a night. No, but God bless. And Peter was the one that introduced us, and he told me about you coming here, and it was very exciting. And you've made a way for yourself, because the competition, you know, with all the people on television today, and it's great that you created your own identity, which is so important.
I think the lack of money helped. I think what happened was...
You don't have an orchestra, you don't have a lot of things, but you have a show that's weak, and it's going.
Yeah. And I think that's the charm. I think that people are not
being
threatened.
Weak, that's it.
Yeah, they're not threatened by talent.
But you know what you have? You know what you have? Which is your opening is so great. When you hit the camera and you do America and blah, 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 yeah. And you do it with this wonderful dummy pain in the ass out here. And you do all that stuff. That's original, and that's great. That's what makes you so successful, in my opinion.
Well,
really.
I think what happens, the reason I hit the camera is because to get it going.
What a night.
Tell me about doing the Orleans in Vegas. I love the Orleans.
Five, six. Anyway.
I'm doing the stand-up again. I see that's a great room there in that Orleans there in Vegas.
It is. It's 50 years. God bless. 50 years in Las Vegas, and I started in lounges and now in the Orleans Hotel, which is a great room for comedy.
Yeah, it really is.
But people say, you know, comedy, we people in comedy, I tell you very honestly, you know, a singer comes out, there's someone like Sinatra, got lucky. But anyway.
One man on earth could say that, by the way.
It's only a joke, Frank. What can he do to me? But, you know, I always said, my mother, rest her soul, always said to me, Don, you're out there, we sell ourselves. We have nothing. We're like bare naked. We come up if you like us. And it's personality. You know, so many times you hear a guy say, oh, that joke was funny. But if you don't like his personality, you get a little uptight. And so we have to sell ourselves. This wonderful gentleman, Craig, and I, every night, we sell ourselves wherever we work. And you get, even when you go to dinner, like my wife says, well, my wife, your daughter, 45 years married, and you know what her big comment is? Is that about it?
I've heard her say.
No, because as Craig knows with his lovely wife, we're always performing. When you meet people, you can't say, how are you, Don? I would like to say, I feel lousy. Leave me alone. We can't do that.
You've done that to me. Wait a minute. What the hell are you talking about? You've done that to me.
Well, with you, I meant it.
All right, okay.
Anyway, no, not seriously. But we're always trying to sell ourselves. And my wife's, I don't know how about your missus is, but in 45 years, that's why I love her, I married a Valium, you know. I go into a restaurant and they'll say, Don, how are you? I go, what do you say, sweetheart? How are you? She'll go, will you stop it? Just stop it. Talk like a person. I said, if I would, you wouldn't have a dime of jewelry.
Yeah. Well, it's true of that. All right. We're out of time, though.
We're out of time?
Out of time.
Okay.
Hey, no!
Try and leave a little more, you know, a little bit of a hug after you're done.
Oh, I see. You know. I see. Hey, this has been a wonderful night for me. I'm going back tomorrow to the States. And, and I wish you the very best.
I wish you the best.
And with your new child, may God be good to you and your lovely wife. I mean it from my heart. You're indeed a gentleman and a great deal of class.
And you, my friend, and Maestro are a legend, and it's just a joy to know you. Don Rickles, everybody. Don Rickles. My only guest this evening is one of the greatest comedians of all time. He would tell you he was the greatest comedian of all time. I'd say he's one of the greatest comedians of all time. All right, he's the greatest comedian of all time. He's got a stand-up tour underway. August the 6th, he's playing Mohegan Sun. August the 20th, the Arcata Theatre in St. Charles, Illinois. And then September the 16th and 17th, he's in Vancouver. Did the lights just go out there? The lights changed there a bit, didn't they? No? Ooh la la! With me, they did. They did, didn't they, Jeff?
Yes, it did.
Yes, it did. Take a look at this. Mr. Warmth, the legend that is Don Rickles, everybody.
That was good. It was good.
Yeah, it was not bad. It sounds like they're glad to see you. I'm still a little, I don't know, but...
You don't have to yell. I'm right on top of you.
Well, I don't know. I like to make sure you can hear me.
Okay, that's it for me.
I like that you're wearing tweed. Is that tweed?
What, are you blind?
Well, I'm just saying. It's a tweed. It's
I don't know.
Nice.
I'm not in the garment business. It's a jacket. I pay for it. I got it.
It's nice. It's tweed. A nice jacket. I was trying to give you a compliment. That's all.
Jesus, you're getting out of control.
I'm sorry. I'm a little nervous. I'm overcompensating.
Don't worry. This show's going to stay on as long as I say so. Nah, it's great. And nice to see you folks. Because, you know, you work a lot of shows. It's in the dark. You know, you don't see the people.
Yeah, yeah.
But here you see the people.
Yeah. And maybe we should be in the dark.
No. Don't put them down. They're all dressed
pretty bad.
Look at this guy sitting here in his underwear. I love when they come in with the jeans. Hey, Rose, what time does the show go on? You get the class. You get the class.
Don't do that scratchy, suggestive
thing.
Well,
I got a fungus. It's from the Navy. Don't worry about it.
This is CBS, buddy. You can't be scratching yourself like that.
I can do whatever I want.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
You came into my dressing room and I got ticks, for crying out loud.
Yeah. Well, do that again.
No. So annoyed with
Yeah, no, come on. Hey, listen, the stand-up tour, right? You're going out and playing the Mohegan Sun? And
oh, yeah, Mohegan Sun. Those Indian places are great, you know.
Now, be especially careful, when, please.
No, they're great. They're great people, especially when the show's on. They keep, hey, hey, now, hey,
see?
Hey. I don't mind doing a show, but, you know, the audience, they're all standing going, oh,
CBS in no way endorses the views of Mr. Rickles or any of the...
Don't worry. With your job, you're shaky. Don't worry about it. They're going to dump you and it's over. Don't worry about it. You know, can I talk? I'm a guest.
I beg your pardon.
The hell is this? A tournament?
I'm sorry.
You got to fight for talk with this guy, for crying out loud. Nice to see you. Are you Chinese? Are you Chinese?
Yeah.
We Jews, we love you, especially on Sunday.
Knock it off. Knock it off.
Why, I can talk. China, very pretty girls.
You can't talk to the Chinese like that. We owe them money.
As long as they keep doing the laundry, everything's good.
Oh.
Hey, 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 like he says. For the money you're paying, that's a funny joke.
Oh, come on, man.
Gee. got to worry about
it. So let's talk to me about this, doing the stand-up.
No, Big, I'll talk to you.
All right, well, I'm just saying, now, I'm worried about you. You've got a hectic schedule. You got
no, thank God, you know, you're working. Mohegan Sun is great. Tom Cantone, he's the big guy there. You don't know him. He's a nice guy.
No, I don't know the big guy.
Stands out in front going, Nicky Walker, Nicky. You give him a cookie and he goes away. Real pain in the ass.
Do you still enjoy doing the stand-up?
Well, sure.
Really?
Gives the wife a chance to put on the jewelry and stand in the house and go, ha, ha, ha. Sure, you know what? It's the traveling. You're a pilot now.
Yeah, well, I've been a pilot for a while, but I don't fly myself.
Well, you can bet your bird I'm not going to go with you, I'll tell you that.
No, did you do flying in the Navy? No, you did some flying in the Navy.
No, Jews don't fly in the Navy. We just stand on the airport and say, here, buy me a plane. No, I was in World War II, the big one.
I know.
You were in Ireland walking around going, did I get him?
I've never even been to Ireland. I'm not from Ireland. I've never been to Ireland.
Where are you from?
I'm from Scotland.
What, that's better?
Yes, it's better.
Sit around all day long going, all right, Charlie, pump it up. Pumping your bagpipes. Get a day job, for crying out loud.
I'm an American now. I'm not.
Let me see your papers. I don't even know.
Look, I got a tattoo right there.
Don't. I tattoo sailors. That shows like you got a lot of class. Don't worry about the tattoos. You don't need the tattoos. You're a big star now. Hide the tattoo. In the Navy, when a guy had a tattoo, he was supposed to be tough. Yeah. You're not tough. I met you backstage. You know, you're a nice guy with a lot of class. You know, and you got a wonderful. By the way, I saw your baby.
Oh, yeah, yeah. My 6-month old baby just met you.
Has a wonderful baby. And the kid's like this. No, it's adorable.
Do you know what's amazing, though? What? I mean this with the greatest deal of respect. He looks exactly like you right now.
In fact, it was a Tuesday night.
Hey!
No, God bless it. It's a, and Megan, your wife, is beautiful, really.
She is. She's got very bad eyesight, clearly, but... do you know she has no sense of smell?
What do you do, sit in the bed all night going...
No.
I love you, honey, but you stink!
No.
Anyway.
She has no sense of smell. She can't smell when I smell. She had some kind of accident when she was a kid. She can't smell anything.
So what?
That's good news for a guy like me.
Put her in an institution and forget about her. Can't smell. Look at the way this conversation's going. I went out saying she stinks, which is a stupid joke to say, and you call her about how she smells. I'm not here to discuss your wife's hygiene. I'm here to discuss why you're still on the air.
Well, it's clearly an oversight. Things go a little late at night. Yeah, CBS.
By the way, you're doing so well. I'm very happy for you. I really mean that. Isn't he? He's really good.
See, you do the old zigzag there. You do that, and then you go like that. Did you ever in your life work with a partner? Did you ever have a buddy or a sidekick or something you did your act with?
No, somebody to, walk around behind me and check us under, trying to pick me off or something like that.
But yeah.
No, I've always been alone because greatness doesn't need a partner.
That's what I try.
I just sit and I take a shower and the water runs up. I go, my God, who am I? Oh. The other equipment just goes, When you're married 46 years, the wife says, I'm in love, and I say, I am too. Give me a minute, I gotta go in the other room and think about it. Anyway, 46 years married, you should
That's
see.
Amazing. Yeah. That's amazing. Yeah.
You'll see her out on Hollywood Boulevard. Psst, sailor. Anyway, I kid about her being a hooker and all that stuff, but
I know your wife's a very dignified and classy woman.
You don't know when you're alone, boy. You don't know.
Yeah.
When she does that bathrobe trick, forget about it.
She does the bathrobe trick?
Why are you getting horny? What's the matter with you?
You told me about the bathrobe trick.
No, we got class, 46. Do you make love often? You see, I give him a little sex and when he went to bed. You wet your pants just then, didn't you?
I was going to say, on my own or with somebody else. That's all I was going to ask.
Now, sex is... See, you young people, remember. Sex is beautiful, but the basis is to be a friend and to care about each other and to wake up in the morning, take a pop, but then forget about it a little bit. But don't base your whole life on boom, 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 you know. I haven't, and that's why this leg don't work.
Do you mind if we take a commercial break?
Hey, it's your show. Do whatever you want.
All right, we'll take a commercial break. We'll be right back with Don.
Welcome back. I'm here with the legendary Don Rickles. Are you all right being called legendary? Is that okay with that?
I don't mind, as long as I'm alive, thank God, you know.
Yeah.
I am now 85 years young, and I feel good.
85? Yeah. Wow. Now, you just... You just started on the Tweety, the Twitter.
Yeah, well, Barbara, that's my wife. You'll meet her later. She's out in the hall going, got a minute? You walk over and talk to her. Lonely broad, lonely broad. Anyway, but no, I just got into it. I know you're into that.
The Twitter,
and she said,
yeah.
it's a good thing for you. And to do these tweets, it's new to me, but it keeps the head going, and I write some funny stuff, hopefully. And I just joined the tweet, and I'm very excited about it.
Now, what's your Tweety handle? Is that Don Rickles? That's it? Don Rickles?
Don.
Don Rickles?
It's Don. I think it's Malibu Bob.
Malibu Bob? Malibu Bob's the guy. Never mind about Malibu
Bob. No, you get pissed off at me. I'm just talking nice.
Well, you don't start to bring up Malibu Bob in my show.
Nazi guy, I swear to God. No, I don't know too much about it because it's the beginning for me, but I'm...
Well, I'm going to help you, is what I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to help you. I got some Tweeties here.
Oh, good.
And then some people have asked me questions on the Tweety.
Ooh. Boy, oh boy, what
did
I...
Did you talk to him yet?
No, I don't talk to dummies. How
hey,
are you?
Don, hey. Hey, like, I'm a big fan of your earlier work.
Thanks.
Before the talkies, I mean.
God bless you.
Yeah, be careful with him. He's spiteful. He doesn't have the warmth
that you have. No, he's a good guy. You don't mean to dress up like that. You need the job. I mean, God bless you, though. You're very good in this. You really are.
Thank you, sir. You're a legend. I loved you in Toy Story. Oh, I'm thinking of Tom Hanks.
That's two he got off. And I'm starting to get a little.
I can help him unplugged.
I've been nice, but the man's trying to make a turn on me.
No, you're right. You were being nice. He was being antagonistic. I can have him unplugged.
Nah, leave him alone.
Did Frank ever say that to you? I can have him unplugged.
Frank who?
You know who I'm talking about.
Frank Sinatra, rest of the soul. He was the best. You brought a man that I adored. He was great. And if he were here tonight, he would break him up.
Yeah, he would.
Anyway,
yeah, I know that.
No, Sinatra was. Somebody special, and I'm going to work with his son, which I'm looking for, Frank Jr.
Oh, yeah.
with his orchestra and so forth, and we're looking forward to it.
Well, what are you going to be? Are you going to be singing?
No, I'm going to be tap dancing in the hall.
Man, it was a perfectly legitimate question.
Oh, what a dumb thing!
What the hell is wrong with you? I was asking you a perfectly legitimate question.
Don't sting me, Craig. Don't sting me. Why would I get out there? I'm a comedian, supposedly. I'm not a singer. I do music and so forth. But working with his son is going to be a big kick for me.
Oh, you must have known him since he was very small.
Oh, yeah. I knew him. Well, he was kidnapped once.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
Was that you?
No. You know what? If it was me, you'd see me now. I'm like, you know why they let him go?
Why?
They heard him humming in the trunk. Anyway, that's a deep story. The kid was in the trunk,
yeah,
and I couldn't find him. And then, hey, don't vote on this stuff. Don't vote on it.
You're not voting. All right, here's another Tweety that's here.
The old man knew about that, see? I don't know who you are, but you're an old man. Anyway, no, how old a man are you?
62.
What?
62.
62? Go to a rest home for... He's 62.
These people are guests.
Look at him, he's sitting there enjoying himself. Is that the wife?
No.
Good luck.
Yeah. Hey, there's one. This is from Oscar in McKinney in Texas. All right, you ready?
Sure.
Dear Craig and Don and Jeff, I recently started dyeing my hair to combat a few grays. Everyone says it is noticeable. Should I stop? Do you ever dye your hair?
Never.
Why not?
Because I'm handsome. What do I have to dye my hair for?
Yeah. Hey, here's your answer. All right, this is from Mark in Fort Lauderdale. You spend a lot of time down in Florida there? Have you been down there?
Hey, that's what... When God says it's time up, that's where a Jew goes. He sits up in heaven going, Irving, Fort Lauderdale, come on! You don't know about that. I do know about that.
I've been
Miami Beach. That's where my mother, rest her soul, used to sit on the boardwalk and say, "Look at the sun. Look at the sky. Look at the sun." And then she'd say, "Where's my check?" Anyway, no, she was a great lady. I brought that up just to keep her name alive. Anyway,
You ready for another one? Here's one from Louisville, Kentucky. Have you ever been to Louisville?
Yeah.
Do you know how to say it properly? You don't say it Louisville, you say it Louisville.
No, you know what you say in Louisville?
What? Dear Craig and Jeff and Doug.
Wait a minute, that's a clever remark. Who else would say something like that?
Here's one. Now, this is a good one. This is a good one for you. I mean this with all respect. You're a slightly older gentleman, so you have some advice here.
Okay.
Right? Okay, it's from a young lady. She says, my younger sister is seeing a guy who doesn't run with the right crowd. How do I kindly tell her to find a nicer guy? Should she run with the bad crowd, the young lady, or?
No, if she's a hooker, she can run with a bad crowd.
If she's CBS cast. I think that's fine, isn't it? That's a reasonable answer. If she's a hooker, she can run with a bad
car. That's right. What else is there, for crying out loud?
Yeah, exactly. All right, here's another one. Dear
really
Craig,
getting on my nerves.
Yeah.
Really getting on my nerves.
My girlfriend saw a few texts from an ex that were rather inappropriate. Ah, you wouldn't understand this. All right.
You know me.
Yeah,
you know me.
Yeah. Like, you just give me a hard time about that. All right, dear Craig and Jeff and guest.
Oh.
All right, there you are. I'm 29 and running for local office. My parents have said that I can't count on their vote. How big of an insult is this?
Well, I would say go in your room, put the covers over your head, and have a game. The hell do I know with these questions?
I'm trying to, because people are going to ask you stuff on the TV.
Is this a parade? What's going on here? I think it's great, though, that people... The tweet is a good thing because it gives people a chance to let out and vent and talk about things. And it's a great thing to do. And that's where I'm going to give it up.
Don't you want... I think you should get a lot of... How many followers have you got already?
I think 25,000.
25,000 already? Yeah. You're just like... You've been on like...
Well, I just started. I just really started.
Yeah, well, I think...
And you see the response. Thanks for wishing me luck.
Yeah.
I said 25,000 and this whole section went...
Well, you know, they're a little scared of you. You've been picking on them.
Why are you scared? I'm a friend. Look at them all. You came in, you stood out in line like you're going to say a big thing. You stood out there all day long. Get jobs. Do work. Do something. This kid, I love the way they dress up. This is real California. The kid down the aisle there with the sandals, with the Jesus shoes and the Mickey Mouse T-shirt. Look at this guy. And the white pins.
All right. Could you just leave it? That's enough.
Come in again when you think it's trick or treat. Come in again.
We gotta go. Don Rickles, everybody. Go. Ah, it's lovely to see you. Over here, buddy, over here. Oh. Right here. What are you staring at them for?
No, that was so sweet to stand up. I guess the underwear stuck. That's so sweet of you, really. When you get older, you know, and you get that kind of reception, you want to walk away and say, why am I with him?
Yeah. I mean, what the hell, Don?
We've been friends. It's good to see you.
It's lovely to see you.
We got that out of the way.
Okay, good. Yeah. You good?
Look at that. Filipinos. Are you Filipinos? Oh, God. 2.5 years. 2.5 years looking for your uncle. Navy. World War II. Big one. Big one. Cebu. Tacloban. Lingayen Gulf. Mindanao. I was there. All. I'll be with you in a minute.
All right.
All trees, all jungle, now big cities, wonderful. We went up to Manila, and MacArthur's still sitting there going, am I dead? God bless you, great country.
I'm not going back there.
What the hell is this, a parade? What happened?
I was doing the emails. This is kind of a thing we do. People send in their problems. I answer them. I'm helpful. I'm a helpful guy. I'm like Dr. Phil.
Well, Dr. Phil's a very clever guy. He really is.
What?
He is. He really is.
Really? You think
he's got a problem? He's on the air. That's a joke, Dr. Phil, if you're watching. He don't watch this. Hit the lights.
No, probably. No. He does. He watches. You know who loves this show?
Oh. Michelle. Why do you do that? You're cutting wood?
No. In a way.
Clever son of a
bitch. He taught me everything I know. You know who loves this show?
Who?
Michelle Obama.
Really?
No, I made it up, but... yeah.
I don't do jokes about the president. He'll get moody and come over the house.
Yeah. Hey, you know what I've been doing? I've been following you on Twitter. You're on Twitter now.
Yeah, and my wife got me on this thing. You know, you write these little da-da-da-da-da-da-da. She said it gives you... That's the way she talks. Gives you something to do. You know. Because she's in the other room going... shining jewelry all the time. That's what Jews do. When they don't work. They just shine... I'm a Jew, don't turn on me, for sake.
Yeah.
Hey, your Christmas is coming up. We're very excited. We have Hanukkah, you have Christmas, and we got it made because we don't have to bother with a tree.
You don't have a Hanukkah bush in the house? What's wrong with you?
Well, the wife. We put some decorations on her and hoist her, for crying. No, Hanukkah, it's all the same. It really, Bob Newhart's my dear friend, you know.
Right.
So we go to his house every, you know, the seating here is great. I'm going to wind up.
Wait, I'll come over to the next.
No, I don't know what you got. Anyway.
We got a little bit of the. Yeah.
All right, lady, we're going to take the left bust.
Yeah.
No, it's true. We have a great time with Bob and with his family and Jenny and all. But my kids, my grandchildren, we all get together and we sit and then Bob reads the book, you know, and blah, 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 and we sit there like we're enjoying, you know.
Yeah. But Bob reads the Torah?
No, Bob doesn't. Bob's still saying Lachaim. Anyway, see, you Gentiles, it's Lachaim, but he can't get that out. It's Lachaim, and I told him that's a ranch in Mexico.
I learned a good...
Don't call me hey. I'm not
a
horse.
No, I got to talk. I learned...
Hey, who no, says hey?
No, I learned a good Yiddish word. Here's my Yiddish word. You ready?
Yeah.
Mishpucha.
You got it right.
Yeah.
A Scotchman saying mishpucha.
Well, because Scottish people have a lot of going on.
That's
yeah.
Right. Sitting around borrowing money from the Jews.
That's right. Well, Scottish people and Jews, they're kind of mishpucha. There. I even used it right, didn't I?
What is this, the Israeli hour?
Yeah,
what is
that?
Let's talk about the... You're an Irishman, right, sir? The guy in the second row behind the Filipinos. You're an Irishman. What are you?
German.
Get a rope.
Oh, oh. Yeah, that's the one that turns against you earlier on.
Now, those days are over, right? By the way, you sir, I don't know, what's your first name?
Don.
My foot, Don. I was in World War II. I never met one of you guys said, my name is Don. No, I'm kidding you, Don, really. But there's a military channel. It tells all about the war, you know, World War II. A lot of good stuff about Germany and what happened and so forth, you know? Snap out of it, huh? I'm talking to a dummy.
I think you're making the gentleman a little uncomfortable, you know what I mean?
Get over it. Go home.
No. All right. Hang on. Hey, a little more of this.
Hey, to all of you, on behalf of this wonderful gentleman, we've been friends now, is it 7 years?
Ooh, at least, yeah.
And he had a baby, and we became friends, and it's nice. I went to his home. You should see his home. You know, Looney Tunes, his home, is it?
When he came to my house for the first time, he gave me $5 at the front door and he said, here's $5, buy yourself a decent house. And I was like, I think I'm in love. Hey, anyone gives me $5, I'm interested. Do you know what I'm saying?
He's got a lovely wife. And the place, I steps put me away, you know. As you get older, steps bother you. My wife says, stop talking about AIDS. Stop it. You know, because she figures if I go, you know, then she's got to give up the house and work the streets, you know. No, Goff, that's not funny. No, you know, you shouldn't talk about death, you know. I don't feel good. No, I feel fine, but...
Yeah, you're
right. Get older and never feel, as you're all young people predominantly, as I look in the audience, always, and you know that too.
What?
Always remember, as long as this working good, you got beyond life, as this works.
Well, there is that. There's a few other areas you want to keep going as well.
I'm just saying. No, you're talking about popping a wife. Don't bring that up.
Do a classy show here, mister. That's not the kind of talk that we expect.
Why not? It's normal. Not with you. You walk onto your rope, stand by the toilet, and go, ha! Anyway. We do it normally.
Yeah, all right.
She lays on the bed, and I go, nah. No, when you're married, you know, you're married. How long are you married now?
3 years.
Good.
Three. What the hell?
Why? I'm not putting it down. I think it's wonderful. Well, I met your wife. She's great.
She's nice.
By the way, the check didn't come.
Sorry, man. I'll get to it.
I'm talking about something else, but we won't go into that. Anyway, but he's married. Lovely wife. The whole secret, and I tell you that, 46 years married. Now, I'm telling you, 46, this is beautiful, you know. That's great. But if you're going to base a whole marriage on, you got trouble. You got to do what I do. Take your mind off it and then go.
We'll be right back with Don Rickles, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. I'm here with a newcomer to show business, Don Rickles. He's a star now. What are you playing there? Do you remember your first gig in show business?
Yeah. Look how quiet it got.
Yeah, I know.
It wasn't a cemetery, I'll tell you that. Yeah. No, my first job was a place called the... Well, not the first job, but when you go back, I remember it called the Sawdust Trail in New York.
Yeah?
Right on Broadway. No doors, no window, just wide open. And when the wind came up, the papers came on the stage. Anyway, it's the truth. And dirt came up and everything. And I stood by a piano, and I had no act, and the guys just sat like that, you know. And some of them had, you know, the major thing with the bird looking around, you know.
No, you lost.
If I'm going too fast...
No, you're going too fast. What's the major thing with the bird looking around? I don't understand. I genuinely don't understand.
Well, I'll walk you backstage. We'll get a look at the bird. Anyway... he's moody today. Really. You know, when you're married a lot, you know, when you get older, you get up in the morning, you got the pajamas, you say, and she says, sweetheart, and you go, and you look down and you go, and he's in there taking a nap. Anyway, hey, I'm too fast. I'm sorry, I'm too fast. No, but that's the point. The point is, we're talking about...
So Christmas. Guys were wearing their pajamas and their penises were hanging out?
Shut up. For the money I'm getting, I'm a riot.
Okay, that's right. You and me both, killer. You and me both.
He's talking like I got to do good here, for crying out.
No, you don't have to do good.
Let's all go over to Ralph Market so watch a fly die on the fruit. That's the funniest thing I ever seen. See, sometimes comedians have to laugh at what they say.
Yeah.
By the way, a great star, he just left the show previous, Robin Williams.
Robin Williams, he was here last night, yeah.
He's a wonderful... You know, with charm and fun, boom. And there's so many young people today that are coming up, and it's great to see. It really is.
A lot of good young comics.
Yeah, and unfortunately, they're here.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I get to see them, and they get disillusioned nice and early in their careers, and that's what works out for them. They get to see what a dark, desperate little room looks like.
No, they don't. They get a big shot when they get over here, really. This doesn't do much for me. Where am I going with you? We're both going to work in the same place in Florida.
What's that?
What's the name of the place?
Hard Rock Casino. Yeah, Hard Rock Casino.
He goes tomorrow. He'll be there Sunday night. Sunday night. And I go the following week. I'll be there. And it works out that way. And so don't suck up all the laughs, okay?
Yeah.
But it's kind of fun. I'm going to be following you.
Yeah.
And I asked you. I said, he's so wealthy. I said, don't you take a private jet? He says, no, Don. I go commercially. But with your money, come on.
My money? What kind of private jet am I going to take? World War II bomber? That's what I'm going to take. I'll be with the goggles on, sitting with the oxygen mask.
You get to sit in the machine gun, Darren. Well done.
I just asked you a question about a play. Machine gun. Machine gun. Oh, the German guy. You know, nobody realizes what? How many shows and sketches you did in your career before you did this.
Oh, yeah, I did them all over.
You did? That's you did? Yeah. How did you, in Scotland, really, what was your first big job?
Well, I used to play...
Oh, you played a horse.
Yeah, I played a horse, yeah. I used to do the sawdust room. It was right there.
And don't be a smart
No, I'm just saying.
No, what did you do, really?
I used to play in bars. I used to...
Me too. That's what I did. Yeah, I got off the trail with the sawdust, but it wasn't pleasant. It was tough. See, today, the young kids, they got comedy clubs, which is great. In my day, in his day, we had to work and forget about it. You know, guy sitting in the front, oh, when's he going to get funny, Rose?
Yeah.
And they always...
They did that thing,
That was instead of applause.
Hey, you do it right, it makes the same noise.
I never dreamed you would top me.
Yeah, I'm not topping you.
No, you can. That's why we're comedians. We're not rivals.
No, that's it. And I'll tell you what I'll do. When I do the Hard Rock Cafe in Florida, the casino there, I'll leave you a little present in the dressing room.
Yeah, like a bomb.
Like a bomb.
You're sweet. It's wonderful that we can go out in casinos for both of us, and for you young people, really, and the elders, too. Casinos, the Indians are great. I worked the Orleans just recently for Tommy Jenkins. No, in Vegas and around the country. It's all casinos. And the Indians come into the lobby. Hey, 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 hey. You know, you wash their horse and they kiss your... You know. Anyway,
It's sad, though. It's sad because, you know, before the white man came, there was casinos all across America.
So what was your first job in show business then, Doc?
My first... I told you that. Now, yeah, no, you I can't remember that. It's so far back. But you know what? I did... See, what I do... I don't do particularly jokes. I do attitude. You know, like this man in the front, right? I'll tell you the truth. I don't like you. Now, that's not a joke. It's the way I said it to you, right, sir? I wasn't mean. I wasn't vicious. As the wife held on to... What are you holding on? Look at him. Woman's holding on like he's going to go... He's got years. Yeah. What is your name, sir?
Doug.
Are you Jewish?
No.
Well, how'd you get those seats? You're Jewish?
I am.
Oh, get up and give her that seat.
All right, hey. We're out of time.
We're
out of time. I'm just trying to be...
Out of time? Yeah. I didn't have to travel from my estate to be out of time, for crying out loud. I have a big estate in Beverly Hills, and I had a slip here to be doing 5 minutes with a dummy when the show's over already, for crying out loud. I don't... These people love me, and I want to get a better job.
Is one of the greatest comedians of all time. One of them. He's appearing June the 21st at the Seminole Hard Rock in Hollywood, Florida, and then at June the 23rd at the Twin River Casino in Lincoln, Rhode Island. Please welcome the man, the myth, the legend that is the great Don Rickles, everyone! That was sensational. You're never going to top that. Oh, come on. What's happening? Don't start already.
I just want to just say, you people were delightful. I mean, I work all over the country. When you come here, you
great audience. I mean, you make a guy feel real home, great. Except in the front, there's always somebody in the front row. It's always like, show. But you're delightful. You really are. And to make this man who was skyrocketed in this business with horse tricks.
It's not a trick. It's an actual horse. It comes out. It moves around. And people love that animal acts. Come on, you must have appeared.
No need to get pissed off.
I'm not. I'm not getting pissed off. I'm just saying, don't be mean to animals. That's what I'm saying. That's a love.
Charlie Hutchot over there.
Charlie Hutchot?
Yeah.
Peterson, yeah.
No, he's good. He's got a job to do. He stands behind that stupid dummy. And you people enjoy it.
Here's the good news. What? I didn't just get a colonoscopy. I also got the endoscope. It went in the other way, too.
Yeah.
I had the full thing.
Yeah, well, you know, the way you drank, you should be dead.
Yeah.
I read your book. I know what you did.
Really? You read my book?
What is this? I got to repeat everything I say?
I read
my book.
Well, I'm touched. I'm moved that
I read your book. That's why I'm on here, because I know it's over. Anyway. No, he had a tough life. He did. He did. He came to America, schmackled a couple of Jewish people, and you skyrocketed. Anyway.
Whoa. What does schmackle mean? I'm not mishpucha. Well, what is
you better start learning, otherwise they're gonna move the desk. Schmackle means, you know, make a fuss, you know.
Yeah.
That's it. The guy in the yellow shirt and the green shirt, you were very good, sir.
Yeah, he was. He's pretty good. Yeah,
where are you from again?
Charlotte.
Seemed to be a lot of fun.
I think a lot of his sense of fun is in the shirt, to be fair.
He was a charming gentleman. I make fun of you because, you know, if New Year's Eve came around and it was you and I in the room, I'd be depressed. But you're a nice gentleman. Good luck. Is that the wife? Ooh. I'll tell you this. It's a joke. You're a pretty woman.
This is, you can't do that.
No, she understands. How long are you married?
37 years.
Is he a mute?
Yep.
37 years. God bless you. I'm married 47. Jewish broad. Just.
Yeah.
Hey. Why did they applaud? You never saw her.
Hey. You why won't you talk to me? I don't see you for ages.
Because I'm going no place with you.
Well, come on. Come and talk to me. You talk to everyone. You talk to the guy in the green shirt.
I got to level with you. You're married now a long time. I was at your house. I was at his house once. You have a new house now.
Yeah, I got a new house. Yeah, and you don't have to climb the stairs to get in.
No, and 48 steps. It's called Heart Attack City, his house. When I went, the first time. And you're still polishing the nails like you do?
Yeah, I still polish my nails.
It puts nail polish on the feet, you know? No, I'm not making this up. And that's why I did what you did. I went,
yeah. You know why I do that? Because I'm not your bitch. No, I do. I don't you polish your toenails?
No. When you find me skipping in the park, you'll know.
I don't know. I like seeing my feet looking pretty.
Yeah,
I
know.
Pretty
I
feet.
Know. I never suspected you for that, you know.
Well, having pretty feet?
No. No, you know, you had a tough life. You really did. Nobody talks about that. But God bless you. You came along. I'm serious now. You came a long way. You didn't come from. Your background was never, you know, like in England now. Hell, mommy, daddy's home. You know.
Yeah,
that's the way they do it all the time. You know, mommy, the war's on. Daddy, the war's on. Mommy, the fighter plane is going down. See. Guys in the army, especially if they were Jewish, going, fire, fire, what, fire, right? I got a gun, I'm going home. That was one of my biggest jokes.
Yeah. You see,
no, I'm just, are you Hawaiian? You're very pretty, are you Hawaiian? No, when I go like this, what, your bust bother you? Are you Hawaiian?
I'm not.
What is your background, what is you?
I'm mixed.
You're mixed, your father was a sailor? Mixed. Let her finish.
I would let her finish, actually.
You crazy horny.
Hey.
He's, by the way, he's married to a very beautiful lady.
Very
he really
beautiful
is. Woman. God bless her.
She, yeah. She paints her toenails too. You don't seem to have a problem with her doing it.
Shut up.
All right.
Hey, well, wait a minute. I'm not through with you. I want to one other thing. You said you're Mexican.
No, mixed.
And where do you live?
Oh, you are Mexican.
See?
See, I'm getting it now. Yeah. I'm getting it now.
I make kids about a kid about Jews, kid about Mexican, kid about black, kid about everything in life. That's what it is today. You said this, you said that. You got to be able to be honest and not be mean spirited or unkind. I say from my heart, really, I don't like you.
We'll be right back.
Looking for trouble.
Welcome back, everybody.
Oh, we're back.
Yeah. I was letting them know that, you know, tone it down a little.
He didn't say that. He's just covering his own, you know. But I got to say this. There's a lot of shows on the air. And since I've known you, really, you've always been a kind of guy that you don't stand and rave and look for applause. You're just a down-to-earth guy. I really mean that. And I'm very delighted to always be on your show. I mean that sincerely.
Well,
really
it's always a pleasure to have you because you're so...
No, it's thanks, though, because you're always so nice to the audience.
Thank you. Pardon me, you always like to have a little Diet Coke. Wife's not here, so...
That's not Diet Coke. Man, I haven't had any in 20 years, but I still got a nose for it, man. I know what that is.
Maybe I'm like, Yeah, and I got news that was quite a thing in those days. And look how you came back. You came back, and now you're a millionaire, and you go every night. They don't know this. No, that's not true. He beat a big problem, and thank God you're a big star now, and you'll never see me again.
You know, sometimes, buddy, you confuse me. You know, you kind of slap me, and then you tickle me, and then you slap me, and then you tickle me. And I find myself kind of...
I'm a sort of a rabbi. No, I tell people they're good things, and then you bring out their bad, but then you coat them with good things. And I coach
that's,
you.
That's what rabbis do.
You'll never find out. Anyway, when you become a Jew, I kill myself.
Hey, let me ask you a question.
Sure.
You know, when I wrap this thing up, I have a...
It's time to move.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
But I don't want to be... I want to offer you the option of going for the big cash
prize. Don't come up with the harmonica, the money, and all that crap. I don't need that, for crying out loud. You go on Jimmy Fallon. Win 3 weeks at a ping pong tournament. I don't need that. I don't need all of that.
Whoa. Fallon's giving away ping pong tournaments?
That's what he does.
How can I compete with that?
You'll never, you're a Scotsman, you don't know. Don't give me the money or the thing and don't say the one question or all. That's, to
just,
me.
Just give you the money?
No, I don't need the money because I know what I'm getting here and I'll be back. Anyway, this is what we call a mercy visit. You understand?
Well, can I offer you a memento of your trip?
That's better. You know what you can offer me?
What?
Nice bottle of vodka and I'll go home early. How about that?
We have
I don't need your harmonica. I don't need your fake phony money that you hand out and all that baloney. I don't need that.
It's not fake money, man.
Well, I don't care. Money. Well, you use it as a good ending because you can't think of anything funny. You don't care.
Wait.
He knows. Hey, he came alive. Hey, that. What's your name, by the way? What's your name?
I'm Jeff.
Really?
And, we really have to have Ed Asner back on the show again.
Ed Asner, what does that mean?
He's been an idiot.
I don't care. What does that mean?
I think he's implying you might look a little bit like Ed Asner.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That was a good one.
Yeah. You want to see this?
Well, what is it, trick or treat? Yeah, okay.
It's a picture of Her Majesty the Queen.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
And I wore the wrong underwear.
Yeah. So that's it.
That was great. She's my age.
Is she?
She's 86 years old.
Well, are you 86?
Would you? I'm 86
years old. 86, right.
May 8th, 1926, besides Her Majesty,
yeah.
Harry Truman, who I adored, a great president. You kids weren't born then.
But he was a great president and a nice man, too. You know,
I wouldn't know.
Did you know any president, American president?
Yeah, I did the White House Correspondents' Dinner when George W. Bush was president.
Oh, you did? Did you?
Yeah.
And my claim to fame was, which was a delightful night, I did the inaugural, Ronald Reagan, rest his soul, I did the inaugural for Ronald Reagan, and it was a great night. It really was.
Yeah.
And then I did those roasts they have on television today with Dean Martin, rest his soul, and again with when he was governor. So I've been around, and yeah. I got two traffic tickets and one for touching a girl on the subway. Anyway,
I think we all learned something. Don Rickles, everybody. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the late night show thing. My first guest tonight, what is he, Jeff?
Oh, he's a legend.
He's a legend, all right. He's one of the all-time great comedians. He's performing March 29th at the Wild Horse Pass Casino in Chandler, Arizona.
Oh, yeah.
We've played that, haven't we?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a good one. And the... It is. I know that one. It's very... Whoa. And the... April the 13th and 14th, he'll be at the Orleans in Las Vegas. That's a good one. Please welcome the legend that is Don Rickles, everybody! That's enough. You get them all big-headed before we start, and it's going to be crazy. How you doing, Don?
Wait a minute. I'm talking to the audience.
What?
The applause was...
I thought it was pretty good.
I'm not talking to you.
Okay.
Next time, throw the clothes in the air, okay? No, you were very sweet and very kind, really. And it was a sweetie, give me that big applause because I'm not staying long. Okay. Got to talk to Scotland here and hope it goes over. Okay.
I'm sitting right here, man. I can hear you.
Why are you yelling? You're yelling. I was in the back. Everything with you. It's the doctor. You're going crazy.
Well, I'm scared.
Well, get abroad and go home early. He's married with a kid, but he don't know it. Anyway.
Two kids.
You have two kids?
Two kids, oh. Yeah. Since the last time I saw you, there's been another one.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Do you wear the pajamas?
Do I wear the kiddie pajamas?
No, you wear the regular long pants pajamas?
Yeah.
And then you do the... And then you do the parachute trick, right?
No, what's the parachute trick? I mean, I've got one breast larger than the other, but what's the...
You couldn't handle it. Jews only do it. You couldn't handle it.
Is it something to do with...
Shut up. You're getting on my nerves.
Okay, come on. Why with this? Why?
Getting on my nerves. I don't know why
I'm getting on your nerves? I'm just trying to be nice.
Look at the audience you got. Look at the kid in the front. The dummy, he don't know where he's sitting. They don't know what's going on, for crying out loud.
If they knew what's going on, they wouldn't be here.
Nah, you're a good guy. You're all right. All those other guys are having trouble in New York. Every time I'm switching shows, you're going to be here in spite of what the people say. I'm done. Your career in a new theater, it's great. I wish you luck.
It's nice in here, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
It's fancy.
Way to fix your dress, huh? Anyway,
What's wrong with her dress?
The one over there, the one that has the dress up where she's smiling.
Yeah.
No, I'm kidding you. She doesn't even know I'm talking to you. You're very stunning.
don't judge the lady in the audience. That's
what,
not right.
This is Germany. Hitler's dead.
Why?
I can do whatever I want. For
well, yeah.
There's a Jewish kid. I said Hitler, and his glasses fogged up. Look at that. Look at that kid there. You know, the one with the nose sucking up the rug.
Hey, now come on now, we've moved on.
What are you begging me? I know what I'm talking about. I'm a Jew. What are you? You're Episcopal. What are you? What the hell are you?
Scottish.
I asked him a question and he panicked.
I don't think it's fair to say that I panicked. I just, you know, I was trying to present you with the information which was accurate.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Mom and Dad are going hunting Friday. Oh, gee. Okay, it's your turn.
All right.
I got to do the questions and the answers for crying out loud.
You seem to be quite happy doing it. I'm just letting you get on with it. That's all. The Orleans, you're going back to the Orleans. That's a great place.
Oh, it's a great,
that's fantastic, that stage there.
It's Vegas. You know, Vegas is what it's all about.
Do you know you're the record breaker in Vegas now? You're the.
Am I?
Yes, you are. Yeah.
I get the feeling I'm talking to a waiter.
If this late night war continues the way it's going, you might well be talking to a waiter.
God love you. God love you.
Can I just tell you about our... our specials today?
You turned on me. Now you're trying to cover it up, but you turned on me.
No, I did not.
Got a little nasty, a little turned on me.
I did not turn on you.
No, it's okay.
I've done it for you.
I can handle it. Jew, shoot him.
Hell.
Turned on me. What were you going to say?
I was going to tell you about our specials. I think that's what I was going to do. I can't remember. And also the Wild Horse Pass Casino. That's a good one. It is. I've been there. It's really good. I have been there. I swear. It's really good.
Do you have a good doctor?
He's frightened to say penis.
I know the Wild Horse Casino. I worked there. I worked in every. You know, and it's we're lucky. You work there too. It's all Indians. God bless them. Really. You come up to the hotel and they go, okay, I know. Okay, well, yeah. And you go to your room, you wash their pony, and you go to bed.
So I just heard they canceled the White Horse Pass Casino game.
Here's your pass.
Yeah, come on. Come on.
Pass this. Remember that in New York? Anybody from New York? No wonder. No wonder it's quiet. Two cockamamie Italians in the back. Where? God bless you. Be from New York. I was originally there, and I moved here. I got a big house now with hunting dogs and a Jewish wife that runs and cleans the lawn. Anyway, but we're doing good now.
Yeah, but
again with the waiter. Stop with this crap.
It's body language. I'm trying to remain open to your.
No, I was at your house. You don't have to make open to me.
I moved house.
Did you really?
I moved house. Remember, you were at my house and you didn't let you.
No, the steps was killing me.
Well, I moved to a place with.
No, he had me invited to his house, and I'm not a kid anymore. And going upstairs is not easy. And he has on each floor. A doctor saying, come on, try to reach the medicine. Anyway,
Well, can I tell you, I know how to throw a party. But the new house, you can just walk right in. Not you, but you just walk right in. You can drive right up, walk right in.
Really?
Yeah, you'll be fine. You come to the new one, you'll be fine.
You wait for me.
Why wouldn't you come in my house?
Because I'm too big. I don't need your house.
Come on, man. You come to my house. You and Barbara come to my house. Everybody thinks I'm doing well in show business. You come to my house.
I came to your house when you had that funny outfit on and playing trick or treat with the maid. I remember that.
That's not me. That's Schwarzenegger. That's not me. That's the other foreigner.
Isn't it great? He got off one good one.
Listen, we have to go to commercial break.
Do whatever you want. I'm leaving.
Anyway. No, you can't. No, you in two segments.
Oh,
you agreed.
Two segments. Okay, two segments. Well, look at the old people over there. Get something for the old lady. She's starting to go. When they start wheezing and leaving their mouth open, it's trouble.
I think she's just excited.
I know.
Yeah. Don Rickles, we'll be right back. Welcome back. I'm here with Don Rickles. Now, listen, I got here, Don. I have photographs that were of you. Look at that. There's you right there. Look at you. Look how adorable you are. Look at that.
That's my wife, and that's Lee Liberace, a great friend of his, and he was wonderful.
Hey, I never met Liberace, but I went to his museum.
Did you?
Yeah, it's got a lot of his stuff in there. I think that he might have been gay.
I have a career, and you can go on by yourself.
All right. Now, here's another one. I like this one. Look at that. This is you with, look, that's Bob Dylan right
there.
That's
right. That's right.
Bruce Springsteen,
yeah,
right?
Bruce the man.
Were you guys in a band together?
You know something?
What?
I'm getting ready to slap you.
See? this is always the same.
With the smart remark, my word, man. Bruce Springsteen, by the way, is a great performer, and this gentleman, of course, is a great artist. That's a long time ago when we all had a couple of vodkas and told each other how great we were. Yeah,
drinking with Bruce Springsteen.
Yeah, well, he's from Jersey. He don't know what time it is unless you give him a drink. Puts on the gloves. America, America. Where do you think we're living? In Spain? We know where the hell we live. Keeps yelling, America, America. Yeah.
He's got other songs, man. Give him a break. He's an American legend.
What are you, a war veteran? In the service. Were you in the service? You weren't in this, sir. I was in there saving your canary. Are you kidding me? I was in World War II.
I know. That's true. That's true.
Those pictures they don't show. 2.5 years in the USS Cyrene in the Philippines, and the Japanese came over to me and said, oh, my children need toys. Anyway, 2 years in the jungle so this guy could have a show.
Hey! Hey, come on.
And I said, I do jokes. I did. I said, I'm an entertainer. And the guy went, entertainer? I'd like, sir, to be in special service. Special service. Okay. And I'd like to do some comedy and have a band, or a comedy and a band. Okay. Next thing you know, I'm in the Philippines, and the guy says, keep firing.
Is that really true?
I swear to God, I was on a 20-millimeter gun. You younger guys, if you know the service, it'd come in little cases, and I had to put it, boom, in the gun. You know, Jewish kid, we don't do that. We had a maid go, lift that. Anyway, you got to give me a minute. I said something that made me laugh.
Yeah. Yeah. How about that, huh? Made yourself laugh. Look at you, Mr. Professional. That's right.
Every night before the show in Vegas, I sit up in my room and I laugh my ass off. So I had a 20-millimeter gun, and the guy said, this is the way you do it. You put it in a casing, and when the Japanese fly, bum, 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 And I said, Captain, I don't do that. He said, no, Rickles, just what I tell you. And every time the plane's gone, I was going, bum, 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 bum. And then I put the casing down and said, can I get in show business? I want to be in show business. And they kept attacking. They kept attacking. No, but they're wonderful people today, and it was a great experience. You were in Scotland inside your mother. Anyway,
Don Rickles, everybody! I know what you're thinking. Craig, why has there not been an email segment on the show?
It's gone.
Let me tell you why, because it gives more time to my first guest. That's why, who is a legend, an American comedy legend. He will be performing at the October the 11th and October the 12th, 2 days right next to each other at the Orleans in Las Vegas, and November the 21st at the Wild Horse Pass Casino. Really, do I have to do all these damn dates? The Wild Horse Pass Casino in Chandler, Arizona. We played that.
That's a good one. That's a good one. Yeah.
Please welcome the legend that is Don Rickles.
The paramedics.
You're all right. What's going on? I've never seen you with a cane before. Are you all right?
No, I'm playing soldier.
Oh, okay.
No, I'll straighten the cap. The cane woke up one morning, had a little pimple on the leg, Why am I on an angle and you're sitting so
far? Well, here, I'll come around.
No, let's not get crazy.
Tell me about it, Don.
Little pimple, and all of a sudden, My wife says, let the doctor come over. I want him to see them. And he came up at 1, 2, 3. And Ann Peters, that's the doctor. And she said, you're going to the hospital. I said, what? You know, turns out that I have what they call, I can't even pronounce it, eGFVOCHOITIS.
Can he say that?
I can say whatever I want. This show isn't going to make it anyway.
He's doing better than I take it.
I don't know, Craig, I really don't know the pronunciation. I always screw it up. No, anyway, it's a disease that eats up on the flesh. It really does.
Oh, no.
No, I'm making it up.
Oh, okay.
So it eats up on the flesh, and it could be very serious. And so I went to the hospital and had 7 operations. Oh, and look at their reaction. Good.
No, I don't think they're saying good. I think they're like, oh.
Yeah. That's good. Jump in when you think of something funny.
All right. Well, let me just move this handle for you here, all right?
Okay.
It's the very, very provocative place. Yeah. It's right there.
You don't understand that God's spider.
Oh. Okay.
And spider gets restless and comes out of the pajamas about 4 in the morning, goes.
What kind of spider are we talking about? A brown recluse? Is that what we're talking about?
A spider that makes the wife smile once in a while.
Oh, she's a patient woman. She's a patient woman.
Hey, when you're 88, you don't do too much of that. You just stand in the hall and say, we did it. Anyway, no, I'm 88. How old are you now?
52.
You look it.
Thanks.
I'll tell you this. No, when you get to be 88, you'll be able to talk about it.
No,
but, no, this show I knew I was going to be on because I knew they have about 4 gurneys in the back waiting for me. So, no, anyway, so this disease eats the flesh, and thank God they caught it in time. And I got a little bit of these operations, and now it works. It'll take a little while and with therapy.
But so you'll get back on your feet.
Yeah,
well,
and I must say that really the doctors were fantastic. They really were. They looked at it and said, leg's got to go. Anyway, no, they didn't say that.
Yeah, I think what happened is that they all went, oh, no.
I wouldn't worry if it did go because Johnny Depp promised me a part on a pirate movie. hey, so folks, I tell you the truth. Everything I say to you, I did up in my room tonight, and I laughed my ass off.
I tell you what, though, does that mean you can get back on the road? Are you going to go back out and do... Oh, you're doing the live dates. You're doing the Orleans.
I've done 8 shows already, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I take the cane and walk out and get around with it, and, you know.
Do you walk around with the cane? You don't
sit down? No, they put skates on my ass.
I'm just saying. Like Bill Cosby now. When Bill does his act now, he sits down. He sits down and he does his show sitting down. Nothing wrong with that.
No, hey, he's a black man. He got a president. He can do whatever he wants. No, Bill's a good friend of mine. You did a little take behind my back.
No, I did a tiny little one. I'm just trying to save my job.
You did a little take behind my back.
I'm just trying to save the job until Christmas, darling. That's all I'm doing.
And then he became a Nazi. 1 minute he became a Nazi.
I'm not a Nazi. We've been through this before.
Okay.
I just like doing a German accent and marching up and down. That doesn't make me a Nazi.
Okay. Anybody got a Valium?
All of them. Particularly that guy that's in Lesbian Row, right? He's had a few.
You were very good, sir. Go to the dentist. Anyway, no, your teeth are great. Your teeth are great. Broads aren't bad either.
Well, you know, that's...
I'm a married man. I'm married now. How long? You're married an hour. I was at the...
An hour and a half.
Short. I've been married. In May, it'll be 50 years.
Congratulations. That's it.
That's fantastic. You people have applauded. You haven't seen her.
Anyway, no, come on, no.
She'll laugh, because with the jewelry she's got to laugh.
Well.
She sits down in Malibu with a ring going, that's a ship. Now, she's, you know, Jewish people always go with the jewelry. But jewelry's gone out of style now. Everything's, you know, fake makeup. You're not a Jewish guy, are you? The guy with the glasses staring at me. You're Irish. Oh, are you a mute?
Can you not? You're meant to talk to me. The whole idea of a talk show is you talk to me, Don. That's the thing. Like, you don't talk to the paid hobos that we grow out of Hollywood Boulevard. You come and you talk to me. They got their candy.
Why would I talk to you? You're going.
Come on.
You're going off the air in about an hour.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I'm only here until Christmas. Come on.
And you're bringing in one of your buddies from England.
Well,
I love those guys. Mummy, Daddy's home. Anyway. Why are they bringing in an English guy, honestly?
You know, I think he's very, very good, actually. He's very good. Yeah. Very talented man. Yes. He is. He's very good. He'll be fine.
Big liar. No, I'm sure the guy will be fine. I can rush over here.
You can come and help him out. You'd be on, because you were on the early shows with me. You said to me, I'll come on your show once it's a hit. That's what you said to me.
Did I say that?
Yeah, you did.
You see the response.
Yeah.
No, you were a hit. You had a nice run. Now you go back to what you usually do in Scotland, playing with your skirt.
That's not a job, though, playing with your skirt. I mean, it's fun and everything, but it's not a job. I'll move on. I'll do something else. I think I'm going to be a detective.
Yeah, that's right. In a Jewish ghetto. Nah, you'll be all right. I know you're having a game show.
Yeah, I'm doing a game show. Yeah.
I don't want to miss that. I got a little twitch.
Yeah. What? You don't like game shows? Everybody loves game shows.
Sure, you know, it's like Fallon, who's a wonderful kid. He said, you want to be on the show? I said, I don't play ping pong. And so, I don't play ping pong. Now listen, that's funny.
Now you know what I felt like during the monologue. That's why we cut straight to you. There was no point in doing it anymore with these people.
These are nice people. I guess the bus hit the wall and they're all here.
I think it's pretty hot outside and they were attracted by the air conditioning. That's what I think is really going on.
No, you always get a nice audience, really. It's not many, but a nice audience. You know, I love over this section, Grandma Moses and a couple of other people.
Hey, come on now. Listen, we have to take a break. We have to take a commercial
break. You don't have to beg. Do it.
All right, then. We'll be right back with Don Rickles, everybody. Welcome back. I'm here with Don Rickles, who's just giving me some career advice and helping me out and being supportive, as you usually are.
Yeah.
I tell you who was here.
This is so exciting.
I tell you who was here.
Who?
It was your daughter, Mindy. She came and did stand-up.
Oh, is that what she calls it?
Oh, come on.
No, she'll be offended by that. I love you, sweetheart. No, she's trying to be fun. And she has my delivery. She does.
Yeah?
I just hope, you know, it was a lot of years. I told her, it's a lot of years. I worked in places where the boss sat with a bathrobe and while I was on went...
I did that when Mindy was on. No, she was good.
That's going to cost you.
No, come on.
No, she's a good kid. She's beautiful, and I wish her luck. She wants to be an actress, and she's talented. She might make it. Because Daddy's getting tired of carrying her.
All right, man. It's okay.
She's got a wonderful husband, Ed, and they do okay. Now, what are we doing?
I was going to talk to you about this. Have you decorated this? Is this something?
No.
It comes like this with all the glitter?
It's Broadway.
This is like some kind of Vegas?
It's Broadway. Thing? You don't know from that. You only know from Scotland. Hey, mommy, daddy, daddy, mommy. Mommy, daddy.
You got the wrong place, man.
Well, you come from Scotland, don't you?
I do, yeah. But
Yeah. Let me see your papers. Anyway, he talks like he belongs here. One phone call, boom, it's over.
No, I'm a citizen now.
Oh, you became a citizen?
No, I became a citizen.
Oh, yeah. That's neat.
Yeah. It's a very, very difficult exam.
Yeah, oh, really?
Yeah.
Hello, America.
Yeah. It's like, do you like gum? Do you hate Al-Qaeda? Come on in.
Get the FBI on the phone.
No, come on.
Get this guy a meal.
What's wrong? You hate the skeleton. Why do you hate the skeleton so much?
I don't say hate. I never use the word hate.
Oh, really?
I met a young man that plays that part, and he's wonderful.
Right.
No, I just said when I was working with him the last time, I didn't know how to handle it because he was talking, and it annoyed me because how am I going to kill a guy like this?
You know, I had that flesh-eating disease once.
All righty.
Just when I was being nice, you turned on me.
Yeah, I know. That's what happened. You always do that to me. What's that? You're playing New Orleans. I like New Orleans in Vegas.
Oh, good. I'll tell them. No, Vegas is still Vegas. I mean, it changed from when Howard Hughes took over, but Vegas, there's something about it. It's always exciting. It really is. Atlantic City is having a little trouble right now, but they'll come back pretty strong. But Atlantic City, but Vegas is having a little trouble. When I was single, it was no trouble at all. A waitress went, is that the tip? Anyway.
Did he say that? He's Don Rickles. He can say what he's damn well pleased. You gotta go. It's good to see you.
Good to see you, and thank you for your time. I'm gonna go to a place now that's a hit. No, I wish you the best. I know you're going to leave in Christmas time next year. But really, of all the jokes and kidding around, you're a real gentleman, and I wish you the very best. You and your wife. He has a lovely wife.
She's very attractive. And
I'll say it. She used to be a hooker in Jersey.
Oh! You went too far. Who would have thought Don Rickles would have gone too far?
But seriously, from my heart, I wish you the very best. You're a charming gentleman and a nice man, and I wish you every success. Good luck.
I love you too, pal. Thanks a lot. Don Rickles, everyone.